Thank you for having me here. Today I came here to tell you about my story, how I came to the point, like to this point, why I started to teach children to code. And I believe that nowadays everyone should know at least basic knowledge of programming, of how to program. My life with computers actually started when I was 9 years old, or maybe even 8 or 7, I don't remember, when my mother took me to her work and she showed me her life. She was a programmer. And obviously she showed me a game, and it was like my first time when I actually touched the computer. And I fell in love with computers because I thought that for me, for 7 years old guy, it was amazing that I could play interesting games. And I'm really into logic, so this is why I like the Minesweeper. But we actually lived in kind of poor conditions, and we couldn't afford to purchase a computer. So when we came here, I asked my mother to make such kind of games in her head and like put all the numbers on a paper. So I was solving the puzzle, and then I was showing her the code. But since that time, I knew that I want to become a computer guy. That time I didn't even heard of a term IT guy or programmer. For me, it was like computer guy. When I came to school, when I started to learn ICT informatics in our schools, I faced many words like this, and I didn't even understand what all of this meant. Like for me, it was like X plus Y and something else. And what's going on? I came here to make like interesting games, and I wanted to become a game developer. I didn't want to do these things. So that was kind of a problem that that I faced in school. There was a lesson, or maybe even two, when I was able to draw a circle. And for me, this was those two lessons were like the most interesting ones, and I really liked them. So I thought that probably there is something that I may like in programming. But eventually, when I finished my school, I didn't go to study for computer science. I became a financial analyst. So I studied for economics in Suleiman University, and after I graduated from this university, I obtained a job in Avon Cosmetics in finance department. I worked there for 5 years, and I grabbed very useful for me experience. And during the time, I was able to optimize all my routine work by 160 hours monthly. So it's almost I like replicated myself. Like there were many routine works in Excel that I didn't wanted to do, and they prevented me from doing like smart things and by doing some analytical stuff. So this is why I always was asking myself, what can I do like to get rid of all the routine? And I think that I succeeded. Moreover, this allowed me to focus on, as I said, on more smarter things. And I was able to optimize costs of our company by $2 million. So I believe that this is 2 million is an incredible achievement. I actually tried to transfer my knowledge and my skills to my colleagues, and some of them like understood what to do with how to optimize their work in Excel, but some people were afraid of a word algorithm. And then I understood that algorithm is just a simple word which is actually just an order of actions, and no one should be afraid of such words. And since that time these are 2 million, two millions for me, and I optimized my work, and my achievement was actually a cost saving one. But for these people, for doctors, they may be 2 million in some other way, which is saving people's life. But all we know that our doctors just buried under all this paperwork, and probably they don't do their like real job for 100%, right? Or like, yes, like all we see that maybe if you know the work of the doctors, they should handle like tons of paper. So I believe that if we teach every child to control computer skills and to actually understand the capabilities of computer, everyone will be able to change their lives. The world of IT is rapidly changing. So, for example, myself, I use the skills to optimize my work and to automate things. But some other people, especially the doctors, can use the skills in some other way and maybe predict some kind of diseases. Or let's say teachers, they can get rid of their own written work. And many other people can get like most of the using computers in the right way. So this is why I believe that everyone should know how to code, and coding is programming, computer science is not a job, it is a profession, it is a skill that everyone should have. And this is why we started Love to Go.
Thank you.